Hello everyone. I haven't played DayZ in years. I've played this for a few hours back in 2014, but that was it. And I was curious, how's the game after all this time? Luckily, I have a friend who's pretty good at the game and he's willing to teach me the ropes and carry me through the game, you know. I heard all kinds of horror stories in anticipation of Frostland release. It seems this is the hardest map to survive on since the release of the game. Let me show you my experience playing it for the first time. So, day one of the new patch, installing and updating the game, all good. Then starting the game, customizing my guy, goddamn, I feel hypothermia installing already. So we couldn't find any official servers up and my friend was reluctant to play on the community servers because they install all kinds of mods, altering the experience a lot. But we had no choice really, we could either play on these or wait a day or two until the official ones come online. So we pick a low ping server with low population and go in. I spawn into a field near the coast on the side of the road with a couple of zombies around. My buddy shows me how the combat works. It's pretty basic and predictable, but it's okay. I like the easy stuff. But then we end up talking on Discord for ages. He was dumping info on me like my life depends on it. Well, and our characters froze in the meantime. Take two now, I spawn near a village called, yeah, whatever that means. Now he gives me a link and starts telling me how you spawn in different places on the map. DayZ having no concept of co-op or party, yeah, you just can't spawn near your buddy. You need to find each other first. So we see we're pretty close to each other, only two villages apart, and I start making my way on his spawn to the west as he started looting stuff already. And I have no clue anyway. I go around the first village and I notice everything starts going down. My food and water and temperature is at lowest anyway, and even the hit points seem to be going down now. I can't expect anything else. I run around half naked in this frozen island after all. Yeah. But luckily I end up finding his town, but of course he's located on the other side of it. And he needs to come and get me. I'm afraid to not pull both zombies if I try to fight one of them. So I sit tight and wait for him. He traps them into a building. That's pretty cool. Now I try to do some combat to put in practice his teachings, but I already forgot parts of the tutorial, so I make a mess out of it. A bit further towards the other end of the town, he brings me into a building with a fire. Yes please, it's nice to see some stats going up for a change. Yeah. You can give other player pills. That's a bit fucked up, but I trust this guy. And Jesus Christ, I get cold when I see what I'm actually wearing. So with the temperature pretty much set, we need to go out and look for food and water. Jesus, look at that broom. It must be the heaviest broom ever. And we go out to scavenge the town. In look for food and water, we find a men's suit jacket, which has better insulation and it's better in better condition than my shirt. So yeah, he teaches me what to do and how to cut my old shirt into rags. A short while later, he finds a hoodie that is pristine condition and has medium insulation. Yeah, moving on, we stumble upon some garages and he points me to a machete on the workbench. Then we find a pair of jeans that also offer better insulation. And then we get into this military checkpoint area or whatever it is. It's filled with zombies and loot, hopefully. This one zombie gets stuck in the tent while I go to the other one, then yeah, she seems oblivious. Then we stumble upon this guy who's all geared up, ready for World War III. My friend tells me in the meantime how what these guys are wearing affects their tankiness. A few shovels to the back of the head and two or so machete swings that were aiming for the neck artery, and yeah, he finally drops. Well, all cool and all, but I'm very hungry by this point. There are funny noises coming from my belly all the time. And I start to get cold again. God damn it. We do an emergency meeting discussing what to do next. There's water to the east, but we got no food. So, time to go gather some sticks to make a fire. The thing is, I'm cold, hungry, and I got some sort of infection. And we don't have much medicine other than some kind of painkillers and a morphine shot. I think I need some antibiotics for what I have. Till the air is, I think I'm slowly dying. And yeah, I start sneezing, and from what I heard, that's pretty bad. That's a bad sign. I need to go sit by a fire ASAP. And yeah, time to go drink some water at least. I will die anyway because we didn't manage to find food. My friend is alright because he ate some stuff before we met in the village, and he only needs water. He explains me how to find water if you're onto one of those dirt roads. But even half dead, I managed to pull some moves. And he manages to find me some crackers. Sadly, I think they are a waste, as I'll soon die anyway. At least we find this narrow dirt path. And he tells me how this leads to a water source. Now we start drinking, we make a fire, then he teaches me to end my misery, you know. Spawning again, I realize I'm 6 or 7 villages east of my loot, and that's no bueno. I don't think I can make it that far. So I repeat the last step. I managed to pull 2 zombies, get a bleeding, but prevail. Then I get chased by another 2 and I figure out if I back myself into a corner, I'll fight them one by one. Things get incredibly messy, I bleed a lot, and yeah. The harakiri number 3. This time I didn't even find out where I was relative to my friend. Then I spawn near the port, further east. Yeah, no good. After a few minutes of running around, I find a gun, a torn up hoodie and a hat. But yeah, who keeps count by this point? Spawning again, this feels somewhat familiar, I believe. Nice. I was tempted to ask for a lift, but yeah, being on this private server, I didn't want to interfere because that was the owner, I believe. So yeah, RIP. And again. Finally, I spawned near my friend, I believe, so I head down south looking for a dirt road that will lead me to the dirt path that leads to my corpse. So yeah, I find the main dirt road, then the path to the water. Then I take back my stuff, drink some water and go meet with my buddy, who settled in a house by the dirt road. The weather turns to shit anyway. He gives me a weapon, tells me how the weapons work in this game, how to aim, how to hip fire, and yeah. At this point I even forgot what our aim was, but I suspect we were just looking for food and stuff, nothing special. Time to make my first fire now. Sitting there, we plan our next move. Our aim is the big city to the west, southwest of our position. On our way there, my friend hears a deer or something and we start moving towards that direction. Ooh, nice texture blending. After 5 or so minutes, he spots something between some trees in the distance. Nice shot, and holy shit, there were 4 or 5 of those guys around. And we didn't even see them anyway. Damn ninjas. Now, closing in, a fox scares us with those creepy screams. I prepare to be helpful, but my friend tells me you don't want to cut meat with no gloves on. So he does all the work. God damn, I feel useless. We load with meat and stuff, I even take the fur and some fat and some guts. Now we go back to cook all the goodies. It looks like we did it, the hard part at least. We started to move towards that big town and cook the meat on our way there. We cleared the area around the farm that's on the main road. Well, we clear it is an overstatement. He's doing the heavy lifting while I try to help here and there. And now the server admin restarted the server, so we decided to log off. After 10 or so minutes, we log back in and start cooking. My buddy is confused with how the meat turns out because we burned a few chunks of deer already. In the meantime, I want to see what I can make with the guts, and apparently you can do rope with them. So yeah, nice, good to know. I found out later you can use that for fishing and perhaps much more. Then I eat some of the meat that wasn't burnt, but I threw it all up in minutes. Then we decide to make a fire outside and try to cook the rest of the meat there. So I need 2 sharpened sticks to do that, so I made those and started cooking, and yeah, while hurting. Apparently I poisoned myself or something. After he pops 2 or so pills in my mouth, my diseased icon disappears and we continue our cooking operation. Nothing out of the ordinary happening, just a chill day in the middle of nature. Then we start moving towards the big city. Having a brain fart, I play around with a smoke grenade I found, and somehow it pops off. I managed to get it to the other room and drop it on the ground, but I got a disease now. God damn it, man. Why? It was all perfect. So yeah, we were laughing about it, and at that time I thought I got something from the food I ate, because I was eating some of the meat beforehand. So he tells me I need some charcoal tablets and start looking at the map for a hospital. This was the second day, by the way, and the server admin installed some mods or something, because the zombies suddenly were loot piñatas. We were finding loot left and right, and there was something wrong with the zombie behavior and numbers. They died too easily and came in, yeah, too many of them. Oh, and they were much slower, Walking Dead type of zombies, you know. Here we are. Hopefully we find those charcoal pills, or I'll die slowly. I found all kinds of stuff, food, a pistol, vitamins, painkillers, everything but the damn charcoal pills we're after. In the end, I decide I'm going to try and eat something, even if I know I'll throw it up later, but maybe I'll prolong it a bit and we find a cure in the meantime. And of course I vomit on my sweater, mom's spaghetti and all that. I find some antibiotics, so I give them a go. I got on the roof of the hospital with no luck. I would have died anyway with no idea what to actually do. We'll make at least one more episode like this, but we'll change servers, because finding that much loot defeats the purpose of this game. Take a look at my first time playing Scum experience. Thank you for watching, and until next time, take care and see ya.